mama if I wasn't whipping this foreign. You gon' have to do more than just say it. You gon' have to do less when you do it. You know I always want you to. You gon' have to do more than just say it. You gon' have to do less when you do it. You know. So you gon' need to do more than do it.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Dylan. Today we're going to be doing a first ever first impressions. And I recently, I don't know if you guys watched my Vegas and LA vlog, I went to the Too Faced headquarters. I want to give a big thank you to Too Faced for having me there. And also mainly, I was there mainly because I got invited by Jessica and Jenny, the Vu sisters. So grateful to even be there and to get so many Too Faced products. I haven't tried a lot of their products. Like, I've only tried like their foundation and whatnot, and I've used their products on clients at work. It's my first time trying it on myself, getting the first impressions on my own face so I can, you know, review for you guys. If you guys would like to see more videos like this, you guys can subscribe to my channel, click that notification bell to be notified whenever I post a new video, and follow my social medias down below as well, Instagram, Snapchat. And if you guys would like to see how I got this look, then keep on watching. So to start off this Too Faced first impressions, I'm actually going to be going ahead and starting off with the Cooling Matte and Skin Perfecting Primer from Too Faced, the Peach Perfect line, Primed and Peachy. On my skin right now is, I'm on Accutane, so I don't recommend doing this at home because my skin is really dry right now, so this is like matte primer, I do not recommend it. So I pretty much, I did already moisturize my face and whatnot. Smells really, really good. It smells like the Yan Yan, or like even the Hello Kitty like breadsticks that you dip in the strawberry. That's what it smells like. Feels pretty smoothing actually. Like, it feels like it's gonna smooth out the skin. Now I'm gonna be going into the Chocolate Brownie brow pencil, and this is in the shade Deep Brown. So it comes with a spoolie and then the brow pencil, similar to the way the Brow Definer is, or the Etude House brow pencil, this shape. Speaking of brow pencils, I like lost my ColourPop brow pencil at the hotel when I was in LA for Gen Beauty back in March, and I was pretty upset because that was that's like my favorite brow pencil. And I lost it, and I had no idea. I feel like the hotel we stayed in, we would lose like everything. Like, I like the shape of it too. It's very defined, like a very, like almost like an angled brush built within the brow pencil. So for foundation, I'm gonna be trying the Peach Perfect Comfort Matte Foundation in the shade Natural Beige. Since my skin is so acne prone, I feel like I would break out from both of these products because I read reviews on it saying that it was going to break out, but I still, you know, wanted to try it anyways. That way I'll know if it breaks out on me. And then the primer is supposed to be this cooling sensation, like a matte primer that also smooths out pores. And with the foundation, it's very transfer proof, humidity resistant, and it's also oil free, and it's also mattifying foundation. It is a medium coverage foundation though. So we're gonna see how this goes. This smells really good. With this foundation, you can definitely make it into like pretty much almost a full coverage foundation because it is a medium, so you can kind of build it up to how you want it. So I would say that this foundation is pretty matte. It feels pretty matte considering the fact that I am on Accutane right now. So again, I do not recommend doing this at home. If it is possible for people who have dry skin, or if you are on Accutane, that to use matte foundations, it's just you really have to really moisturize. It looks really good besides all the dry parts of my face from the Accutane. For concealer, I got both two shades of the Born This Way concealer from Too Faced. I got it in light nude, and then I got it in light medium. I'm gonna go ahead and go in with the light medium for concealer today. Smell the coconut water. It reminds me of the way the Born This Way foundation smells. I'm gonna blending this concealer out with a beauty blender. I am honestly so not used to this texture of concealer since I usually use the more liquidy matte ones. Even the ColourPop concealer is more like a liquidy and it dries to matte. And this one is more like that dewy finish, which I actually prefer more than the matte. And don't forget that since I'm on Accutane, sometimes the concealer would lift up when I use a beauty blender, so I'm just gonna go in with one of my Luxie brushes. I'm gonna go in with the concealer again on certain parts. Like this area that kind of lifted up. And then that's for foundation, so I'm gonna go ahead and kind of blend it up into the concealer we already have. Now for powder, wasn't able to get either the Born This Way powder or the peach powder. I guess it was either or of the ones that I let, I let either Jenny or Jessica have. I was like, oh, you guys can take it because there's only two or a couple left. So I'm just going to set my under eyes with the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder as my usual. And then I think I'm going to be going all over my face with the Becca Hydra Mist Powder. For eyes, I was not able to get the Too Faced Shadow Insurance. Because honestly, I got so much stuff, I felt bad for taking everything. But I'll try it next time. So for now, I'm just gonna use my MAC 24 Hour Extend Eye Base for eye primer. I'm gonna be going into the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. Never actually tried this palette like on myself before. I've swatched it a couple times at work. It's something I wouldn't buy, but I'm glad I got the opportunity to actually get it, you know, for free from Too Faced. And I'm gonna go ahead, see if you haven't seen it a million times already. And it smells like peaches. And I'm gonna be going into White Peach and Peaches and Cream to set my eyelid. I'm also going to be trying out Too Faced brushes, which I'm so excited about because they look really, like, really nice brushes. Oh, it actually also comes with a makeup bag, too, that you can store your brushes in. That's so cute. I had no idea it comes with a bag. I'm also going to be pulling the Too Faced Chocolate Gold palette as well. We can mix and match with the palettes. I've always wanted this palette, and then finally got it from Too Faced. Thank you so much again. For my transition shade, I think I'm going to be going into Candy Peach Puree and Summer Yum. So be extra and blend like three shades together, because why not? I'm going to be using the blender brush from Too Faced for my transition shade. So I'm going to grabbing into Candy Peach Puree and Summer Yum, kind of mix those shades together. So I don't know what I was expecting, but these shadows blend really nicely. Like, I've only played it once or twice at work and I didn't really care for it as much, but no, they blend really, really nice. For the outer corner, I'm going to be taking the contour brush, and then I'm going to be mixing Tempting and Delectable. I'm going to start blending the shadows out. I feel like that contour brush wasn't the best outer corner brush. I mean, it wasn't bad, it's just, I feel like it was a little bit too big. I should have used my smaller brush, but I wanted to try the brush, so there is that. For the lids, I'm going to be taking the green shade, which is Bless Her Heart. Every time there's a palette that the main focus is like other colors besides green, I always look at the green or the blues, because one of my favorite colors is like blue, like shade family is like the blues and greens, so it's just natural that my eyes would gravitate towards the green color of a peach palette. So yeah, I'm gonna put that on the lid. I'm going to be also mixing a little bit of the green from the Chocolate Gold palette from Too Faced. I'm going to get Money Bags. I'm just going to put a little bit of that on top of the mixing with the other green shade that we did as well. So the green definitely added a little bit of something. I love the green. I'm living for the green. I'm going to be taking the Demolition 24/7 Glide on Eye Pencil from Urban Decay to go in my waterline. For the lower lash line, I'm also going to be blending it out with these Too Faced liner brush. And then I'm going to be going on the lower lash line with a Candy Peach shade. This brush is a little bit too scratchy for my liking. Cancel that. I'm just going to be going in with one of my brushes. For liquid liner, I got like a ton of the sketch markers. I'm going to be going into the papaya peach shade, which is very fitting for the liner. And it's a felt tip liquid liner from Too Faced. It is waterproof. It looks like a pen. It's sort of like a pen. It's really cute. So I'm going to be lining my eyes with this one. I'm like shedding so much dead skin because of Accutane, and you can kind of see the foundation kind of emphasizing a little bit. There are certain foundations that I can get away with wearing and you wouldn't be as this much peeling. I feel like with this one, it's best. This foundation is best for combo oily skin because it's a pretty matte foundation. It's not the most matte, but it is pretty matte. For contour, I'm going to be first going in with my Fenty Mocha Matchstick as per usual. For bronzer, I'm going to be taking the Chocolate Soleil bronzer from Too Faced, one of the most popular products from Too Faced ever. This is actually really nice. I've used it a couple times on clients at work. I haven't actually personally tried it on myself, but I know for a fact that I think I'm gonna like this one for a bronzer. And it's like a neutral tone kind of bronzer. Kind of warm, a little bit warm, but still neutral, not like the most orange of bronzers. I'm gonna be taking the Mr. Right brush to apply it. Great for if you wanna make it more tapered to contour with. And then bigger for when you use blush and whatnot and so on. Smells amazing. For highlight, I didn't grab any of the Too Faced highlights, so I'm going to be going in with the Anastasia Nicole Guerriero palette. Having used this in quite a hot minute, and I'm going to be taking Forever Young Go-Getter and let's say Lit 143. For blush, I'm going to be taking the Too Faced Love blush in the shade Baby Love. Now, when I swatched these blushes, I was surprised. I didn't think they were going to be pigmented. They gave really nice color payoff, and I can't wait to try it on my cheeks. And look how cute this is, and look at the packaging. So cute. And like you see the Too Faced logo, and then there's bunnies on it as well. I'm also going to be using the Mr. Right brush to apply my blush. It rhymed. I'm going to be taking the shade Nectar and Luscious for my inner corner highlight and brow bone highlight. I'm going to be setting my face with the Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray. Actually, I'm also going to try the Festival Refresh spray from Too Faced as well, from their Unicorn Festival collection, and I want to try it. Why not use a setting spray and another spray to be extra? Because that's what I am, so get on it. Oh, it looks like this. It's like a refreshing spray, so it's not like a setting spray, it's more like a refreshing spray, so I'm going to try it. Woo! It smells like Skittles. Like, this smells like Skittles. It smells so good. And it feels really refreshing. Like, super refreshing. Going to be then curling my lashes and then applying mascara. This is the Better Than Sex mascara from Too Faced. I've never ever tried it. This is not waterproof. I usually go for waterproof mascaras. I don't know why I didn't just get the waterproof version at the Too Faced headquarters. I don't know why I just got the regular. I forgot. Anyways, I'm still gonna use it for the sake of this video since it is a Too Faced first impression, so why not just, you know, try it and use it. I guarantee you it's not gonna work out for me because it is normal like a regular mascara, which means I have, as you guys know, or may not know, I have straight lashes, and when I apply regular mascara, my curl will start going down before my eyes. So that's definitely gonna happen for sure. Yeah, my curl is like already starting to go down. At first it was more up, now it's just going down, like it's just drooping. Like there's only a very slight curl. Still kind of there, but it's not as curly as it used to be. But yep, drooping again. Both of them are pretty much borderline straight now. This one's like totally straight. Like, just for lashes. Too Faced doesn't have lashes, so I'm just gonna be applying the Allure Luxe Baroque lashes. These are like one of my new favorite pairs. I actually got this one at Gen Beauty, and it's so pretty. Like, they're so pretty on. It gives you that faux like mink effect. For lips, I'm just going to be putting on the Too Faced Melted Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade Sell Out. And this is the finished look for my first impressions. Anyway, since I keep getting interrupted, because of the fact that I'm going to do a roundup of all the products of what I liked, and honestly, I liked a lot of the products that I used today. Like, I'm completely pleasantly surprised. I don't know what I was expecting, but I liked a lot of these products. So let's start off with the brow pencil, the chocolate brownie pencil, and the dark brunette, I believe. Yes, no, the dark brown, the deep brown, in deep brown. And this is so nice because it glides on so smoothly, and it's so pigmented, and the fact that I like it better than my Etude House pencil, actually, which is the Drawing Brows Eyebrow Pencil, which is the one I use now since I lost my ColourPop brow pencil. Like, that brow definer, Anastasia sort of like brow pencil. But yeah, I really like this one because it glides on smoothly and nicely. I can get away with using this without using like a dip brow, even though I always add a dip brow or like a pomade. I really like the Born This Way concealer as well because it's different from your normal like full coverage matte concealer. It's like more of like a medium coverage dewy concealer, and I prefer dewy over matte any single day and any day because it blends out so nicely. It looks like skin. Yeah, I really like this concealer. The sketch marker felt tip liners from Too Faced are really nice, very easy to use, great color payoff. And if there's a little bit of a gap, it's okay because you can just keep filling in, and it doesn't look ridiculous or anything. Like, it looks really smooth. It's not cracking whatsoever, and good for beginners. I would highly recommend this for beginners if you're getting into liner. The Chocolate Soleil bronzer is nice, a great all-around bronzer. You can get away with contouring this one just because it's not too warm. It is more on the neutral to warm side, but yeah, also great for bronzing. And then the Love Flush blushes are really nice. I'm really surprised at this one because I don't know what I was expecting, because I thought this was more for aesthetic purposes, but no, it is actually a great blush, because not a lot of people talk about this one. That's why I thought it was just like more for aesthetic purposes, but I really do like this one. As for the Too Faced eyeshadow palettes, they're great palettes. I wouldn't say I highly recommend them, but they're great. They're really nice. If you have like money to spare and you want to buy like another palette just for funsies. Why did I say funsies? I never say funsies. Anyways, if you just like packaging, I would say get it. I mean, it's beautiful. It smells good. I have to say though that Too Faced shadows blend out really nicely. I mean, I've done it on clients at work before. It's just that doing it on myself is like, wow, like they blend really smoothly, and they build pretty nicely too. The liquid lipstick is so comfortable on the lips, like I can hardly feel them on the lips because it is more of that thinner formula, but it dries really nicely too. It dries, you don't feel it drying like some liquid lipsticks do, especially the ones that are more drying. Really comfortable liquid lipstick. The color payoff is great. I really like this color. It's the sellout color. I love, like, you know, that more peachy sort of nude color. As for the Peach Perfect face products, the primer and the foundation, I don't know how I feel about them yet. Again, I am on Accutane, so I'm not getting the full effect of the foundation, but I do recommend this. I recommend this more for people with normal to oily skin, because it is a matte finish. Dry skin, you can use it. It's not impossible. You just have to really hydrate and moisturize, and also exfoliate as well if you have any dry patches. This one's really gives a really cooling sensation. It feels really smooth when applied on. Again, not a lot of primers do that for me. I usually don't use primer nowadays. I just use my moisturizer, and that's like good for me, and I'm good to go. This is great for the upcoming summer months because it is transfer resistant and whatnot. Like, and it's also humidity resistant. That's what one of my managers says. Yeah, great for the upcoming summer months, great for special occasions. It's great for the summer as well because it's a really good refreshing spray. It smells good. Brushes. The brushes are really, really nice. Out of the set, I would say a brush that I really recommend if you were to get a brush from Too Faced would be the Mr. Right brush, because this is an all-around great face brush. You can contour, bronze, blush, powder, whatever you want, desire for this one. It's a great complexion brush, especially for the powder products. Really, really soft. Really nice shaped. It's almost like tapered as well. I like tapered face brushes. They're my favorite. Now, my least favorite product that I've tried today, and I probably don't even know if I'm going to use it again, I probably won't, is the Better Than Sex mascara. It's pretty underwhelming to me. Again, I usually wear lashes anyways. I don't wear mascara on its own like I used to before I even started wearing lashes. But from what I can tell, my lashes are drooping, so not for me. I could have gotten the waterproof version, so maybe I'll try that next time if I ever get it. But yeah, I don't recommend this one. It's not as hyped up as people make it seem to be, in my opinion. So that is it for my Too Faced first impressions. I hope I was helpful to you guys in any way, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. Yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.